Hi everyone. In today's video, we're going to go through how to debug a Java stream pipeline. One of the beauties of stream pipelines is that they give us a little bit of an insight into functional programming within Java, but one of the downsides is that there are a lot of little optimizations that happen, and it's difficult for a debugger to sometimes be able to trace through what's happening during a stream pipeline. So today, I'm going to unravel the mystery and show you, at least with IntelliJ, how you can get an inside look into how the pipeline's working. Without further ado, let's get into some examples. So for the first example, let's make an integer n. We'll go ahead and give it a value of 10 for now. And then what I want to do is I want to get the sum of all numbers from 0 to n inclusive. So I could say result equals int stream dot range. And then I could say 0 to n. And then I can just use the sum method right there. So the range method here starts the int stream. And sum is a terminal operation that sums up all the values in the int stream. And then I'll go ahead and print it out. We run the code, and the result that we get here is 45, which actually is incorrect. The result we want is 55. So it seems like the n here isn't actually getting included, but if I wanted to debug this, what you might think you could do is you could add a breakpoint, and then if you run this in debug mode, you would think that if I use the step over here, that I could then look at the state of the int stream, but I can't. The debugger isn't giving me that information. And that's because being able to step through a stream like this is non-trivial, and a debugger can't do it in the traditional way, so we have to do it a different way. So if I stop this here, instead what you want to do is you run the debugger, and there's this little icon right here. If you click on this, this says trace current stream chain. And this is a great insight into what's actually happening. So over here on the left, you can see 10 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and I forgot 0 right there. And then it's saying this is the sum of all the elements. So you can see what's happening. There's a split mode and there's a flat mode. In this case, the stream pipeline isn't very complicated, so they don't really show very different things here. But the point is, we can see immediately that int equals 10 is missing. So what we could do is we could read the documentation here on the range method and see that the start index is inclusive and the end index is exclusive. So we could either do n plus 1, or the other one we can do is we could do range closed. And if we hover over the ranged closed documentation here, we can see start inclusive, end inclusive. So let's rerun with the debugger again and trace the stream pipeline. We can see that now we have int 10 at the end and the result of 55 like we would expect. So now that we've done that example, let's do one that's a little more involved. Let's have a string array and let's manipulate it in multiple ways with a stream pipeline. All right, so here we have a more complicated stream pipeline. So we have our string array, and now what we're doing is we're doing a set of operations on it, and then the stream pipeline actually terminates with this find any terminal operation, but then it returns an optional, which then can have multiple other chained methods that can be added onto it as well. So the stream pipeline technically ends right here, and then the optional has an additional thing if the optional doesn't have a value. And then we print out the value right here. So if we run the code, we get a value of 5 here. Okay, so what? So what does that 5 actually mean? So let's do what we did last time. Let's add a breakpoint, run it in debug mode. And again, to reiterate, if we use the step function, we're not getting anywhere here because we're not figuring out the intermediate state of this stream pipeline. Instead, what we want to do is we want to hit the trace current stream chain button. Now we have something to work with here. Okay, so let's do split mode for a second. So we start with all the elements in the stream. We sort them, but one thing you'll notice that's pretty interesting is we're only sorting 3 elements. We're not sorting all of the elements. I wonder why. Let's go ahead and keep looking. And then we call peek, which calls system.out.println. So we would expect that the console to be printing out these various elements here. We map them to a particular value. We filter out all the ones whose string length isn't at least 3. And then we find the first one and we get the value of 5. And we don't have to worry about the or else here because the or else isn't part of our stream pipeline. So one thing I want to stress again is sorted only sorted three elements. And the reason is because the stream pipeline was optimized. Let's say that I didn't need to find any here. Let's say that instead I want to return a list of everything. And now instead of having an integer result, I want to have a list of integers. And I need to import this. Now if I were to run this again, and we evaluate the stream pipeline, we sort everything in this case, and you maintain the same size of the stream at the end. And when we map it, we map out the same values, and then we filter everything, and we put everything in the list. And that's because we need to compile everything that could be filterable, therefore we have to evaluate everything within the stream pipeline. It's kind of interesting to get some of the insights into how the different stream elements can be optimized depending on what the terminal operation requires. So another thing I want to mention is if I go to the console window, there's currently no output here. And we're using the peek method, which goes and prints each element as it enters through the peek method. If we evaluate the stream pipeline, we'll notice that we're going to get stuff logged to the console. Now this little icon has been lit up. If we look, we can see that the IDE actually executes a chunk or all of the stream pipeline in order to build up that overall mapping of the elements. So under the hood, that's what it looks like the IDE is doing, and that's why you have different things get executed here. So one potential word of caution, I haven't tried this, but it'd be interesting to see if you did a non-reversible operation on a data structure, if you would be able to recover it within the debugging session because the stream pipeline gets executed whenever you click on this button. That does violate some of the purest methodology of functional programming, but that's a whole other discussion. Now, another example I want to give is the debugger can show all the extra elements that are added in your stream pipeline. Thus far, I've only been filtering out elements. Let's go ahead and add some elements via a flat map. This time we'll do arrays.stream of my data, and then we're going to do flat map to int, and we're going to say string chars. And then we're going to say to array. So now we want to return this whole thing. So let's do final int integer array results. And then let's format this a little bit. And then we'll print out the result. And we'll use arrays.toString in order to format the output better. All right, so basically what we have here is we have our original string array. We're converting it into a stream. And then we are condensing a stream of streams, where string.chars is a stream that gets generated over each string. So now we have a stream, and then we have a stream within a stream, so we have a stream of streams, and flat map to int is going to map that all into a singular flat container. And then we convert it into an array here at the end. So essentially we're converting this array of strings into an array of each of the characters within these strings. And you can see the output here. But if I run this in the debugger, we can see that it produces the expected output as well. All right, now if we go to flat mode, we can see all of the mapping here. So we can see that hello maps to all of these elements, world to these, etc., etc. I think this is a pretty neat view to be able to see how all of the different elements within a stream map across different stream pipeline operations. I wasn't aware of this functionality of the IDE until somewhat recently, and I wish I knew about this a long time ago when I was debugging streams, because seeing this visual is honestly really useful. And that was a quick rundown of how to debug a stream pipeline within the IntelliJ IDE. I was really excited to see this feature when it came out because it allows you to visualize a stream pipeline. And for those of us who are visual learners or look at things visually, this is really useful for being able to see how a stream pipeline gets executed. If you enjoyed today's video, please do smash that like button. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.